Class, this is a video recording for first topic in P2, which is module 8 about electrophoresis. Okay, so first things foremost, let's define first what does electrophoresis mean. So i-break down natin yung word na electrophoresis para mas maintindihan natin yung pinaka-concept niya. Okay, so electrophoresis consists actually of parang two words na pinagsama. First is electro, meaning electricity, and phoresis meaning separation. So when combined, electrophoresis actually means separation by means of electricity. And then in the picture that you are seeing here in our right side, this is actually a device for electrophoresis which will be used inside the laboratory. Although on personal experience, I haven't actually used electrophoresis machines such as this one. But it is very important for us medical technologists if ever you will be assigned in a laboratory wherein there will be an apparatus such as this one. And of course, kailangan alam din natin yung principle and kung para saan ba siya ginagamit. Electrophoresis is actually a laboratory technique used to separate DNA, RNA, or protein molecules based on their size and electrical charge. I repeat po ha. In the previous lessons from, I think, module 5, kay batch extraction, SPE, chromatography, lahat yon, di ba, nagsiseparate tayo ng components. Here in electrophoresis, just the same, we are separating various different components. However, ang parang pinaka-basis ng separation here is on their size and electrical charge. Huwag kalilimutan, dapat tandaan. Again, electrophoresis is a lab technique used to separate DNA, RNA, or protein molecules based on their size, yung laki po, and of course, yung kanilang electrical charge. Is it positive, negative, ganun po. Kaya nga siya, electrophoresis. And again, electrophoresis, pag pinagsama yung dalawang word na electro plus phoresis, it means separation by means of electricity. So gagamit tayo ng electricity or current using this technique. Okay, so here is another illustration of our electrophoresis. So, most commonly, ang ginagamit po sa electrophoresis is actually a gel. So, gel electrophoresis po ang tawag doon. Is a technique, again, commonly used in laboratories to separate charged molecules like your DNA, your RNA, and proteins according to their size. And then, charged molecules move through a gel when an electric current is passed through it. Okay. So here in this illustration, for example, here is the sample wells. Ayan po nakalagay, di ba? Sample wells. And then, ito po yung sample wells natin. This is the origin point kung saan po natin ilalagay yung sample or yung specimen nyo. And then, using the power supply, mag-generate po yan ng electricity or electric current. And then, magkakaroon ng parang passage ng electricity here in the gel or yung medium natin, and then mag-move po yung particles or the difference, kunwari na lang proteins, example, based on their electrical charge as well as yung bilis naman po nung paggalaw nila is yung size. Okay, an electric current is applied across the gel so that one end of the gel has a positive charge. Positive charge, and the other end has a negative charge. So, ito po ang positive charge. Ayan. Ay, nakalagay yun, plus. And then here is your negative charge. So negative electrode po. And again, the movement of charged molecules is called migration po. Diba kasi ito po ang ating sample wells. For example, dito nyo po ilalagay yung inyong specimen. No? Example na lang, serum. O, lagay nyo dyan. Ngayon, yung movement po, kasi makakakita kayo ng movement katulad here. When an electric current is passed in this apparatus, yung ating sample, di ba, from here, gagalaw po yan based kung anong protein yung present dun sa sample na yon. And then, ang tawag po dun sa paggalaw po nung molecules is migration. I repeat po, the movement of charged molecules in electrophoresis is called migration po. Molecules migrate towards the opposite charge. Baka narinig nyo na yung kasabihang the opposite attracts. So,
Anong ibig sabihin nun, ma'am? Kapag ang sample mo is negatively charged, magmamigrate yon sa positive charge. And vice versa, kung naman positive yung sample mo, magmumove naman si specimen ngayon doon sa negative charge. So, yun po yung parang basis niya. The opposite attracts. The migration will depend on, again, the electrical charge, kung positive or negative, and that molecule will move in the direction of the opposite charge niya po. Okay, so opposites attract. Ayan. Then, smaller molecules migrate through the gel more quickly kasi nga po mas maliit sila. And therefore, travel further than larger fragments then that migrates more slowly and therefore will travel as a shorter distance. As a result, the molecules are separated also by size. So, again ha, sa electrophoresis po, dalawa yung pinaka-basis natin. Number one, electrical charge. Positive ba yan? Negative? Then, depending on yung charge niya, dun siya gagalaw, the opposite attracts. The second basis natin again is, sabi nga dito, is separation by size. So, kung mas maliit daw po yung sample, mas mabilis po yung galaw niya. Kapag naman mas malaki yung sample, mas mabagal yung galaw. Tingnan natin ito, yung gumagalaw na animation sa baba. So, example natin, yung large na sample. Ito, nakalagay large. Tingnan nyo yung migration niya. Okay, na nag-migrate siya hanggang dito lang. Ayan, hanggang dyan lang. Kasi nga po, malaki siya, mabagal yung paggalaw niya. Unlike, dito po tayo kay small sample, di ba? From here, yan, napunta siya sa pinakadulo. Mas mabilis po yung pag-travel ng smaller molecules in comparison with larger molecules po. Okay, so yan po yung basis natin sa electrophoresis why a certain substance only migrates up to this point. Parang ganon. And then the gel consists of a permeable matrix, a bit like a sieve or salaan. Alam po ba kung ano yung salaan? Yun yung salaan. Wala akong picture, pero yung sieve guys, salaan po yun. So meron yan sa, ano nyo, sa kitchen nyo. Yan, yun po yung sieve. Isipin nyo na lang, parang may mga maliliit na butas here in this gel. Ito pong color blue na yan actually. This is your supporting media. Na sabihin na lang natin, sige na gel. And then yung gel po na yan, para yan may mga maliliit, sobrang liit na butas. It's not visible with the naked eye. But yun nga, mukha siyang sieve in microscopic level. Meron siyang sieve. And then yung molecules po, doon po yung parang way niya para mag-migrate siya. Kasi kung isang solid na substance tong gel natin, hindi makakagalaw yung molecules kasi naka-block yan. Unlike kapag ganito na somehow meron parang maliliit na butas doon po sa ating gel, meron siyang parang sieve-like structure, makakagalaw po ngayon yung molecules natin. Thus nag-happen yung migration na tinatawag. Okay, so ayan po, another illustration. Binalik ko lang kung ano yung nakalagay here. Ilagay ko lang ulit dito. Ganito po ang itsura ng electrophoresis device. So again, the principle, separation, again, mainly of charged materials by differential migration across a surface or through a column in an applied potential gradient. Migration rates, again, depend upon the size, your shape, and charge of the species. So yun talaga yung pinaka main concern natin here, yung size talaga, yung shape, somehow, kaya pang anhin yan eh. Somehow, yung shape kasi related din dun sa size niya. But for now, let's just focus on electrophoresis basis on size and charge of the particle. Okay? And then, apparatus and instrumentation, ito po yung mga ginagamit. Ito po yung mga nakalagay dito. Ayan, yung paper, cellulose acetate, polymeric gels, ito po yan, dito yan, sa supporting medium. We also have, of course, yung electrolyte solution, enclosed tank with electrodes and buffer reservoir, and of course, your power supply, kasi nga kailangan po natin ng electricity to conduct this type of technique. And then, we also have a variation of the traditional electrophoresis called capillary electrophoresis. It has a narrow bore fused silica capillary tube. It has an injection system, a detector, recorder, or VDU. Mamaya po may picture din tayo ni capillary electrophoresis para mas ma-visualize natin yung apparatus na naka-enclose here in capillary electrophoresis. And then this is the applications of this method. Guys, madalas pong ginagawa ang electrophoresis inside the laboratory. It just depends on what type of laboratory you will be working with. But for the most part, if yung mga simple na laboratory lang naman, clinical lab, I don't think na nag-i-use na electrophoresis as parang pinaka-basis na technique for separation. Then, ano lang siguro to, sa mga special laboratory, siguro mga research lab ganyan, baka makakita po kayo ng electrophoresis machine. Okay, then these are the disadvantages of the method. It is very sensitive kung ano pong supporting medium yung kailangan yung gamitin. And precision, poor for quantitative work by traditional methods. Just the same with typical analytical methods, kapag repetitive yung work, marami yung workload, it can actually affect your precision po. So, what are the different factors affecting ionic migration? So, aside from the size, di ba, meron tayong sinabing na size kanina, and yung charge ng particles, meron po pong different factors affecting the migration itself, yung paggalaw po ni molecule. Then, in conventional electrolysis, cations, natatandaan pa po ba kung ano ibig sabihin ng cation at yung anions? Diba yung cations po, cations is the positively charged molecule. I repeat po, pakitake down notes pala. By the way, magsulat po kayo ng notes ngayon. Cations are the positively charged molecule. And yung anions natin is the negative charged molecule. Next, di ba ang sabi natin kanina, the opposites attract. So kung ako isang positive, ang lalapitan ko is negative. That's why your cations, which are positively charged, moves toward the cathode. Sorry. Again, I repeat po, sorry. Ang ating cation, since positively charged siya, it will move towards the cathode, which is the negative electrode. I repeat po, cathode is the negative electrode. Huwag kalilimutan, dapat tandaan. Cathode is the negative electrode. Again, I repeat po ha. Cathode is the negative electrode. So, si cations again, di ba, positive siya. O, the opposites attract daw. So, lalapit siya ngayon sa negative electrode natin, which is again called your cathode. Then, next one, just the same with our cathode, yung mga anions naman natin, which are negatively charged particles, will move towards the positive electrode called the anode. So, para hindi niyo makalimutan to guys, kung sino po yung negative and positive electrode, baka kasi malito po kayo. Mga estudyante kasi, napapansin ko sa kanila, pinagpapalit nila yung cations at cathode. Feeling kasi nila magkaparehas lang yung meaning niyan. Guys ha, magkaiba po ang cations at cathode at yung anions at anode. Magkaiba po yun. And then, para lang hindi makalimutan kung sino po yung positive and negative electrodes natin, please use the phrase, don't panic. Again, I repeat, please remember the phrase, don't panic. Panic meaning positive is anode, negative is cathode. Again ha, please remember the phrase para hindi makalimutan kung sino yung positive and negative electrode. Don't panic. Huwag kang magpanic kapag tinanong ni ma'am sa'yo bigla sino po yung positive electrode. So, positive electrode is the anode, negative is cathode. Yan, so, panic. Yan, don't panic. Okay. The next, another factor affecting the ionic migration is the rate of migration reaches a constant value when the attractive force exerted by the electrode is balanced by frictional force due to movement of the species through the electrolyte solution. That's good to know. Each species characterized by its electrophoretic mobility. So the different kinds of molecules that you will separate using electrophoresis actually has parang may mga characteristics sila, which is determined by its total charge ng mismong particle, the overall size and shape of that molecule, and viscosity of the electrolyte solution. So, si electrolyte solution kasi is actually a part of the apparatus itself. So kung viscous masyado, hindi appropriate yung viscosity ng electrolyte solution natin, of course, it can affect the overall ionic migration of the technique. And then the distance, then represented by letter D, traveled by a given species is related to its mobility then. The time of application, baka naman kasi hindi mo sabay-sabay nilagay dun sa sample wells natin, yung ating sample. So of course, it can affect yung migration. And the size of the potential gradient can also affect the distance traveled by a molecule in electrophoresis. Okay, another factor we got is of course your temperature, pH, and ionic strength of our molecule is affecting the overall migration. Then sabi dito, as mobility and rate of diffusion both increases with increasing temperature. So kung mas mataas po yung temperature than required dun sa ating technique, mas bibilis po yung mobility and yung rate of diffusion natin. Kaya dapat sa isang laboratory talaga, meron lang certain acceptable temperature, which is, I believe, room temp around 20 to 25 degrees, depending on what type of parang mga test yung pinaperform inside that lab. But for the most part, dapat ganon. Kasi once po na nag-increase yung temperature in the surrounding, in the supporting media, or the device itself, it can affect the mobility and yung rate of diffusion inside the sample. Makaka-affect na yan sa result natin, di ba? Hindi na accurate. So, temperature is affecting the overall migration. And then, the net charge and hence the mobility of many species, especially organic compounds, is pH dependent. Kasi yung pH scale din natin can affect the parang overall charge of a particle. Kung natatandaan sa normal na chemistry or yung organic chem natin, nung nagpapangalan tayo ng mga different compounds, kung ito ba eh, acidic or basic sa ANACHEM last period, di ba kapag ang mga acids kasi natin, ang kanilang chemical formula, laging merong hydrogen. Di ba? Kunwari, hydrochloric acid, chemical formula niyan is HCl. Yung H po kasi na yon, that is positively charged, yung hydrogen. So, kapag ganon, madalas kung yung pH is acidic, positively charged yung substance. Eh, what about naman yung mga basic natin? Mga basic substance natin like sodium hydroxide, yung NaOH, yung chemical formula. Yung OH po, yung hydroxide, is negatively charged. So, basic yun, di ba? So, again, yun lang naman yung parang explanation why the mobility of many species is pH dependent, because yun na nga, kapag yung acidic na substance, most of the time positively charged sila, at yung mga basic na substance is negatively charged most of the time. Okay? And then to ensure that the migration characteristics of the components of a mixture remain constant during separation, the electrolyte solution employed is usually a buffer. Ang buffer po is nagko-control po yan ng pH. Okay? Mamaya, pakita ko sa inyo kung ano yung buffer. But, ayun nga po, just to give you an idea, a buffer is a solution which controls the pH. Marami kasi tayong nilalagay dun sa electrophoretic gel natin. Okay? Then, that can affect the overall pH of the device kung saan tayo gumagawa. And if that's the case, di ba sabi nga natin, ang ating mobility ng molecules is pH dependent. Kapag po kasi biglang na-alter yung pH natin dahil sa mga nilalagay po nating solutions, sample, whatever, it can affect the overall test natin, yung pinaka-result. That's why a buffer should be employed to control the pH of the environment using electrophoresis. And then in an unbuffered medium, pH changes could lead to gross changes in ionic concentration. So ayun nga, very sensitive po sa temperature, pH po, ang ating electrophoresis. Okay, then next topic that you're seeing here in connection with electrophoresis is electroosmosis. Ma'am, what is electroosmosis? Explain ko lang in layman's term kung ano po ang electroosmosis. Then, Ang nangyayari po kasi, 'di ba, kapag gumagalaw yung mga molecules natin towards the positive and negative electrode, 'di ba, kasi the opposite attracts. So gagalaw yung molecules ngayon kapag nilagyan mo ng electric current. What happens is, since meron somehow parang water, important po kasi, by the way, important po ang ating electroosmosis sa capillary electrophoresis, which is mamaya didiscuss natin much further. But to give you an idea, inside the electrophoresis apparatus, meron po dong parang water molecules. At ang nangyayari po is kapag gumagalaw yung ating mga molecules to the negative and positive electrode, it can actually carry water also. Sabi nga dito, during the migration of cations and anions towards their respective electrodes, each ion tends to carry solvated water along with it. So, parang nagkikerry siya ng tubig tuwing gagalaw siya, yung mga molecules natin. What happens is, ito pala question, mama, ano pong nangyayari kapag naman neutral yung ating molecule? Kasi di ba meron tayong positive yung cation, negative yung anion. Eh ma'am, ano po nangyayari dun sa neutral? Ang nangyayari guys dun sa neutral is nag-i-stay lang po siya sa place niya. Hindi siya gagalaw kung saan mo siya nilagay because wala nga po siyang charge. Neutral siya eh. However, what happens here in electroosmosis, since kasi nung gumalaw po yung mga molecules natin towards the positive and negative electrode, it carries water. At yung water na yon guys, can actually also carry yung neutral species natin. Ayan, sabi nga dito, electroosmosis results in a movement of neutral species, yung mga wala pong charge, which would normally be expected to remain at the point of application of the sample. Okay. Kaya, yun nga, very important yung charge of the molecules here para mas magets na siya guys. But ulitin ko lang para lang mas mabilis or mas okay yung pagkaka-explain. Kapag po merong movement ng positive and negative molecules, it carries water din. So wala. Ano na yan eh. That's given. Nagkikerry po siya ng solvated water. At yung water na nakikerry po ng movement ng ating mga molecules, can actually carry din po yung neutral species. Hindi naman sobrang as in, sobra yung movement niya, hindi ganon. But normally kasi, we expect the neutral molecules to stay in place. Kasi wala nga silang charge, di ba? So saan siya pupunta? Wala naman yung opposite attracts doon. Kasi nga, wala siyang opposite. It is neutral, wala po siyang charge. So hindi siya dapat gagalaw. However, what happens in electroosmosis is gagalaw po ngayon yung neutral species natin ng paunti-unti due to the carryover of desolvated water due to the migration of molecules. So yun po yung electroosmosis. Very important yung electroosmosis na yan guys, sa capillary electrophoresis. So mamaya pakita ko rin sa inyo. And then, these are the different supporting media that we can use po for our electrophoresis. Ito yan. And just a device natin kanina. Wait. So, balik tayo dito. So, example, ito po yung ating electrophoresis machine. Ito pong nasa gitna na yan. Hindi lang kita. Meron po yung supporting media. Ito siguro, feeling ko gel to. Kaya hindi siya kita. So, clear yung itsura niya. Ito din. Nandito po yung supporting media natin. So, dito po magkakaroon ng migration na tinatawag. Dito nyo yan makikita, yung paggalaw ni molecules. Ito po ay yung supporting media. So, tayo doon. Yung supporting medium po natin can be made out of paper, cellulose acetate, and your gels. But more commonly, guys, gels po yung ginagamit. But just for a reference, sige, for paper, it is cheap and easy to use, di ba, kung saan-saan lang makakahanap ng papel. However, there can be poor resolution of migrating species due to tailing. Yung tailing, guys, parang may smudge, parang ganon. Yun po yung pwedeng mangyari when using paper, so it is not recommended to be used. However, cheap pa rin siya at easy to use. Madali kasi makahanap niya. Next is a cellulose acetate. It separates the molecules by its molecular size. So kung gaano kalaki, ganun yung rate ng migration niya. It gives sharper bands, it is more easily rendered transparent and low solvent capacity. At it enhances the resolution para mas makita nyo po kasi yung bands. Okay, and then the more commonly used or most commonly used worldwide is yung mga gels po natin for electrophoresis. It has a resolving power enhanced due to sieve effect operating. Yung mukha nga pong salaan, di ba? Parang may mga butas-butas na sobra-sobrang liit na hindi nyo makita yan. But meron po yan. It has a sieve-like structure, thus mas maganda po yung parang migration ng substances natin. It is prepared from starch, agar, or polyacrylamide. And then may mga example nga po akong nilagay dito, which is your agarose gel. Yung tawag, it separates by electrical charge. And yung polyacrylamide gel po natin separates on the basis of charge and molecular size. So both. Then ito pa guys. During migration of the molecules, kapag katapos po kasi niya mag-migrate, di ba kasi nagkakaroon ng migration? Ayan. In real life, guys, in real life, hindi nyo po yan agad-agad makikita. So, kumbaga, parang transparent yan. Katulad na lang din dito sa, ano natin, supporting media natin. Di ba? Makikita nyo ba? Hindi nyo yan makikita without the use of staining. Okay, again guys, I repeat po. Using the supporting media in electrophoresis, once you are done, di ba, nalagyan mo na ng kuryente. O sige, nag-move ngayon yung molecules mo. Yung molecules guys, hindi po yun agad-agad makikita kung nasan man siya, kung nasan yung parang area niya dito sa ating supporting media. We need to use different stains to visualize kung nasan po yung tinatawag natin mga bands. So, example nito, ayan. Nakikita ba yan? Ayan, mga bands po yan. We actually use different kinds of stain to see kung nasaan po yung migration ng ating mga molecules in electrophoresis. So, we need to stain it. And ito po yung mga different commonly used stains for visualization of the fractions or bands using electrophoresis. We have Amido Black B, Ponchu S, Oil Red O, Sudan Black, Fat Red S, 7B, Kumasi Blue, and Golden Silver Stain. Yung ating silver stain and gold stain is very sensitive even to nanogram quantities of protein. So very sensitive po ito kahit konti na detect niya. And then, ganito na po ang itsura ng ating electrophoresis machine kapag meron na po tayong stains for visualization. Ayan, di ba may mga kulay na. Nakikita nyo na yung bands ngayon. Then, yun yung babasahin natin. Using densitometry, technique po ito, it measures the absorbance of the stain and concentration of the dye and protein fractions. And it also scans and quantitates electrophoretic pattern. Yun po yung basis natin kung paano natin nababasa yung para amount ng mga different molecules here in these bands, we will use densitometry. Kasi hindi mo naman pwede sabihin, ah, kasi nandito po yung kulay, kaya ito po siya. Kailangan pa rin naman natin siyang i-quantitate. Then we can use densitometry for that. At ito na nga po, yung capillary electrophoresis, it's just almost the same with your traditional electrophoresis. Medyo iba lang po yung kanyang setup. Okay? So kung nakita kasi kanina, di ba, yung mga supporting media natin. Yan, di ba? Ito po yung itsura ng traditional electrophoresis. Di ba parang flat lang yung surface and then ito po yung supporting media. If we will differentiate it, yung kanyang setup kay capillary electrophoresis, you can see na nawala na po yung flat surface here and it is pinalitan ng ating ganito, which is called a capillary tube. Kaya po tinawag na capillary electrophoresis. At kung nakita nyo, may parang liquid supply here. That's why nga very important po ang electroosmosis here in capillary electrophoresis because if you can see the setup, meron talaga ditong mga parang tubig. So yan po ha ang setup ng ating capillary electrophoresis. And the separation here in capillary electrophoresis depends on electrophoretic mobility as well, just the same with traditional electrophoresis. However, meron pong nadagdag na basis which is electroosmosis po. So yung mga neutral na particles natin, maka-quantitate na natin siya ngayon. Hindi naman, guys, hindi naman kasi lahat is merong charge. Okay? Hindi po lahat may positive or negative charge. Hindi po ganon. Meron tayong mga neutral pa rin molecules na kailangan pa rin naman nating i-detect, and we can use capillary electrophoresis for that. Then these are the different detectors po for capillary electrophoresis. Yan, UV vis absorption, fluorescence, laser-induced fluorescence, amperometry, spectrometry, and so on. And then ito po yung mga detection limits nila using these kinds of method. Sige nga, question. Kung nakikinig ka maigi, ano po yung method para ma-detect natin yung sa traditional electrophoresis? Yung stain. Paano natin naka-quantitate yung molecules dun sa stain? Nga, ano nga ulit yung sinabi ni ma'am kanina, di ba? That is densitometry. Yun po yung ginagamit natin to detect the absorbance of the stains using the traditional electrophoresis. However, here in capillary electrophoresis, ito po yung different methods. Marami siya para ma-quantitate natin yung parang concentration ni molecule. At ito po yung detection limit ng mga different methods as well as yung concentration detection limit at the advantages and disadvantages of the different methods. Then ito po. Set up ulit ng CE or capillary electrophoresis. Ayan po. Yung mas complicated na itsura niya, but ito lang naman din yan. Same lang. And then, principal modes of high-performance capillary electrophoresis. Ayan po. Here is your separation mechanism kung paano nagsiseparate ang different molecules using these kinds of techniques or modes. Here are your separation medium kung ano yung ginagamit. Ito guys ha, yung HPCE, high-performance capillary electrophoresis po yan. And then, these are the typical sample types that you can use using these modes. Then, here are the different buffers that you can commonly use in capillary electrophoresis. Then again, sabi ko nga, di ba kanina, ano nga po ulit yung buffer? Kasi di ba si electrophoresis, very pH dependent po siya. During pag-load ng samples or kung ano mang nilagay natin kay electrophoresis, it can affect the overall pH of the environment. So, si electrophoresis nga ma'am, pH dependent eh. So, konting mali ko sa pH, magbabago na po yung resulta ko. Then, ang solution doon guys, para hindi maging sagabal yung pH na masyadong pH dependent si electrophoresis, is we can use buffer solutions. A buffer solution is one which resists changes in pH when small quantities or acid or an alkali is added into it. So, para hindi magbago masyado yung pH kahit sobrang dami na nating in-add dun sa electrophoresis natin. So, yun po yung purpose ni buffer. It retains the pH of the environment. Regardless kung maglagay tayo ng acid or base dyan, constant pa rin yung pH ng ating environment. And then, ito nga po, yung different buffers commonly used in CE. Yan po. Paki-take note po ako. And then if you want more explanation regarding electrophoresis po, you want to see how this is being performed inside the laboratory. Ayan, it must in-explain pa using a different animation and illustration. You can click this link